This is how you prepare an image for print in Photoshop. Hey everyone, welcome back to the Visual Center. Today I'm going to jump into Photoshop and we're going to show you how to prepare an image for print. Now something you want to keep in mind when printing is color space. And if you don't know what color space is, check this video out. You're going to want to match your color space to the color space that your printing services use. So it'd be a good idea to call them ahead of time and ask them which one they prefer. And if you didn't know, we do fine art printing here at the Visual Center. If you'd like to give us a try, go to thevisualcenter.com. There'll be a link in the description below. And the color space we prefer using is Adobe RGB 1998. Let's jump into Photoshop and work on an image. I have an image here, and I've already done all the color correction, retouching, and editing that I want to it. And the color space is already set to Adobe RGB 1998. Color space is something I set before the editing process starts, but you may not have, or your color space might be different from what your printing service prefers. If you do need to change it, you can go up to Edit and down to Convert to Profile. For more information on that, you know what to do. Sometimes this change can result in a shift in colors, so take the time now to make any changes before moving to the next step. And it's also worth reminding you that you should be doing this on a calibrated screen. The next step I'm going to take is to set my aspect ratio and image size. And if you remember in previous videos, Trent and I both talked about how there is a difference between aspect ratio and image size. We start by setting the aspect ratio with the crop tool. For this image, I'm going to fit it into an 11 by 14 frame with no mat. So I'll set my aspect ratio to 11 by 14. And I'll adjust my composition to the new crop. And hit enter. Now that my ratio is set, I'll set my image size. The shortcut for this is Command Option I, or Control Alt I if you're on Windows. I need to make sure that my resolution is set to 300 dpi. Now, if your image is not set to 300 already, then you'll want to go through the following procedure in order to maintain the quality of your image. Let me go ahead and open up a file that is not ready. And here you can see that my file's resolution is set to 72 dpi instead of 300. So if I need to make changes to this to maintain the quality of my image, these are the steps that I want to take. First, I want to uncheck resample. Then I want to set my resolution to 300. I'll then go back down to resample and check it. And now I can change my width and height to what it needs to be. Let's say it was 10 inches. Make sure to subscribe and stay tuned for more videos about resolution and scaling your images. For now, a quick tip is if your image is scaling up, use Preserve Details 2.0. If it is scaling down, this bicubic option is a good setting. So now I'll go back to my original image and make sure that this one is set properly. I don't need to uncheck resample because my resolution is already set to 300. So I can go ahead and skip to the next step, which is to set the width and height. I was trying to make this image fit an 11 by 14 picture frame. I've already set my aspect ratio with my crop tool. So if I type in 11, I should get a perfect 11 by 14. Click OK. Now we just need to save the file. I always save it out as a new file so I can always go back to the original if I need to edit anything. So File, Save As. And by the way, you do want to do Save As, not Export. Exporting in Photoshop is now Export for Web, and it'll actually change your image back to 72 dpi and undo all the settings that you just set your image to. So I'll go ahead and name my file here, Print Ready 11 by 14. I'm already set to a TIFF. You can choose different file formats. There's TIFF or JPEG, which are fine for printing. You'll notice that I don't have JPEG in this list. In order to find JPEG, a regular JPEG, not a JPEG 2000, you'll have to hit the Save a Copy button. When you do that, you'll get the full list here. And here's a JPEG. And that's it. You now have a print-ready file you can send to the Visual Center. Or a printer of your choice. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Thank you.